Mexican government persecuted all Christian beliefs. But no other religion was more attacked than my faith, the Catholic faith. I was only 14 when the persecution began. But I watched as my own people were tortured until they either renounced their faith or were killed. As you would come into the town by train, you could see the power lines were shadowed by the hanging bodies of those who chose to die in Christ's name. They were martyrs of the church. And I knew that if my time came, I would gladly die for my king. My mother cried as I went off to fight my war. But I told her that in order to go to heaven, we have to go to war. On January 25th, the general lost his horse, and the Mexican military chiefs were catching up to us. Without hesitation, I yelled, "Take my horse! You are the general! Save yourself! What am I worth to the cause?" As the general fled on my horse, I had nothing to do but wait. And when the time finally came that I was taken prisoner, my father did everything he could to try and have me released. Rafael Picasso, an officer in the Mexican military, took me to a church that they had been using as a holding cell for condemned Catholics. As I arrived, I was angered to find Rafael Picasso's roosters running around, desecrating this beautiful church, this house of God. So in the night, when everyone was asleep, I grabbed and I snapped the neck of every rooster in that church, and I hung them on the communion rail. This angered Picasso, so he sentenced me to death by firing squad in the town's church. The morning of the day of my death, the guards noticed that I had no shoes. And they asked me if I wanted any, but I responded, "Why do I need shoes? All I want is to go to heaven." With this, it cut deeply into the soles of my feet, forcing me to walk on the rocky path all the way to my grave. As I walked, I saw the puddles of blood that I left on the rocks I had stepped on. And they began to tear apart my back with their machetes. With every slice, I would yell, "Viva Christo Rey! Viva Christo Rey!" Which means, "Long live Christ the King." Every couple of minutes, they would tell me that if I just denied my faith and said death to Christ the King, they would let me go. My only response was, "Viva Christo Rey." When the time finally came and I stood at my grave, they told me this was where I was to be buried. And I said, "This is good. I forgive all of you. I will see you all in heaven, and I want you all to repent. One last time, they asked me to deny my faith. And one last time, I responded, "Viva Christo Rey! Viva Christo Rey!" This made them angrier than anything I had said before. And they began to stab me repeatedly. And with every stab, I would yell, "Viva Christo Rey! Viva Christo Rey!" As I lay dying, they told me they could help me. And all I had to say was, "Death to Christ the King." I could never think or say those words. As I lay dying, I felt no fear. Only joy in the fact that I was about to give my life for my King. It's only fitting he gave his life for me. My last seconds,
took my blood, and I drew a cross in the dirt. At this moment, a gun was put to my head. I closed my eyes, and in one glorious moment, I was in the presence of my King for all eternity. Viva Christo Rey!